The Democratic National Advertorial is taking place in Chicago right now. A person who, like the rest of us, is rolling her eyes, but has to pay attention because that's kind of the job. Wonderful Megyn Kelly in the United States. Rockstar, how are you? But let's talk about what's happening outside of the venue, because the protesters are dressed as either abortion pills or people who say that Joe Biden and Kamala Harris are killers and should go to hell.
So it's just your average Democratic National Convention where you could kill your baby or kill your balls with a vasectomy in like a to-go truck. You could swing by the Days of Rage Palestinian protesters who are promising to entice the police into fighting so badly that they wind up with bruises as their back-to-school outfits. So they're having themselves a normal one so far. Inside the arena, we have Joe Biden telling us he's not angry at all, but he's saying it like this, I'm not angry. And so all of his body language and tone suggests that he's a very angry man. And we know why. They shoved him out of this role. I would have done it myself if I had been a Democrat. I did not think he could do it 4 more years. I don't blame them for shoving him out, but he was shoved out. And now they want to pretend that it was voluntary. And you have crazy, crazy Nancy Pelosi with her Joe Biden sign, go Joe. Meanwhile, she was the one who stuck the knife and twisted it. There's no person more responsible for ousting him than Nancy, but she wants us to believe she's totally Team Joe and she prays every night their relationship is still intact. The whole thing is just debauchery and fraud. That's what I've seen so far. Just the celebration of killing babies in the womb. And this is, again, not a pro-choice, pro-life comment. It's if you're pro-choice, that's fine, but you shouldn't be out there celebrating the murder of your child, like the killing of your child. At least normal people know abortion is at least the ending of a potential life, to be very charitable to the pro-choice side. You should be out there celebrating it. Dressed up, what's next? Like dress up like a little scalpel and walk down like with the little remains? I mean, it's just so, in such bad taste to be marching around Chicago as an abortion pill. And they want us to believe that they're the pro family, you know, party. So we're going to celebrate abortions and we're going to celebrate vasectomies. And then we're going to swing by the Palestinian protesters who are throwing bloody shoes in the faces of Joe Biden and Kamala Harris pictures. So I don't know what they're really trying to telegraph other than they're extreme.
What's your sense about where the protests go? Because my thought was that if it was the issue that the Joe Biden night would be sort of the night where they were most angry because this was the person who's in office right now. But do you think that they're going to ramp it up and some of the nuts that was on display in day one by that final day? Because they clearly want their 1968 moment. They want their moment, as you say, to get into the fight with police, to remind people, hey, you know, don't fall for the line, stay angry. Do you think that they'll remain where they currently are, or there is a day of crazy coming this week?
Well, we heard that they were going to go at it their hardest the first night and the fourth night, the night that Joe Biden was speaking and then the night that Kamala Harris is speaking. And if last night is any indicator,
yeah, it
really
ended up
not
being
a news story.
Yeah.
You're slightly annoying. You didn't really, like, make a lot of news headlines. Not that I'm looking for them to. I'm just saying this was their promise, and it didn't really happen. And honestly, like, the mayor of Chicago is a far left socialist, but my money's usually on the Chicago PD. I lived in Chicago for 5 years. The Chicago PD does not F around. And I would be shocked if they were not able to handle this influx of protesters who have been there for quite some time. I was just in Chicago last October, and they were out there then. This is post the Israel response, I mean, the attack on Israel and then the Israeli response. And they were all over the place. And the Chicago PD had them well in hand. So if they managed to escalate to the point where they lose control, you know, law enforcement, I'd be shocked.
Now, you know, all of these parties, when they have their conventions, we all know that it's not really about anything serious. It's just about the feels, the vibe. And we know that the vibe has got them to a place where maybe they're winning, but on the issues, which remain things like the economy and immigration, that ain't budging, no matter what has happened with the froth and bubble of it all. And she made a massive strategic mistake on Friday when she came out with what was allegedly economic policy. But, you know, the establishment people of the New York Times and the Washington Post went, yeah, this is garbage, let alone people who know even more about it who say, yeah, this is garbage. And then in one of the, you know, I think grand total of 10 minutes where she's been off the teleprompter, she says, oh, it'll just all pay for itself. I reckon that if people were sitting and waiting for the wobble of who has she changed from what she was, we have seen no. And in the period of time after the advertorial to the debate, she is in a world of trouble when it's talking about the number one issue.
The economy, right. She got panned from the left and the right on what was universally decried as gimmicks, a gimmicky speech on Friday about how she, with the hand of the federal government, is going to single-handedly change prices at the grocery store. Meanwhile, the grocers generally have a 1% profit margin. How is she going to stop them from their price gouging, make them operate at a loss? That's not what's going to happen. Her inflation is what's caused increased prices at the grocery store and the gas pump. And she's trying to dodge it by saying it's these evil corporate greedy people who are trying to exploit the poor working class. That's not what happened. They spent too much. The Fed printed too much money and they drove up, the cash influx in the economy, which leads to inflation. That's what we're dealing with over here. And she can blame it on the evil corporate greedy people all she wants. But there's only so much she could clip the wings of the grocers without making groceries disappear. So that's number one. Then she wants to offer everybody, first-time homebuyers, a $25,000 mortgage down payment. Okay, we're already suffering from a housing shortage. And, you know, I said this on my show yesterday. You give everybody who's buying a house for a first time $25,000 to buy a house, you know what's going to happen? Every seller is going to increase the price of the house by $25,000. That's how it's right. going to go. That's what yep. happened on the college campuses. Every time they increase the amount of loans that you can borrow as a student, the tuition goes up by that exact amount. So none of this is going to work. And I think she knows that, but the Democrats have long run on, here's your free stuff. We're the party of free stuff, whether it was the Obama phone back in 2008,
that's
you know,
right.
Obamacare, which is going to pay for medicine for everybody, and we're going to become more like Canada. To her now with these nonsense proposals that when, as you point out, she was pressed on how she's going to pay for, because we're already, $35 trillion in debt. She just said, you just wait to see the return on investment. You just wait until like your kids grow up and they're somehow more productive. So it's like, wow, we're really going to play the long game, because right now those same kids are saddled with this $35 trillion and no one knows how they're going to repay it.
This is the bit where somebody is going to clip this on the internet. So I apologize, Megyn, that you're in the split screen here. It feels like the feels part of the campaign has begun to top out. And we know that that basically is bringing it back to a 50-50 race. Truth is, in 2020, where Biden ended up with more than 300 electoral votes, he was winning states by only tens of thousands of people, as Trump did in 2016. The reality of the American electorate is that it is very, very tight. Are you starting to get the same feeling that we're just, rather than the guaranteed win of Trump versus Biden, we're back to the traditional red versus blue, and it's a very tight line?
I am, and I'm also seeing the cracks in each foundation. You know,
yeah.
You're pointing out that she went off script a time or two, and it was disastrous. She was terrible. But I don't think that the Democrats are going to be persuaded by one big fall. You know, she's going to say one really stupid thing, and they're going to turn on her, because they already would have turned on her. There's so many stupid things to choose from. If you were that kind of voter, you already would not be in Kamala's camp. But I do think, if you're talking about those critical swing state voters, the ones you just mentioned, you know, the tens of thousands, net, if she keeps speaking, they're going to be reminded that she is not a smart person. I don't care. I'm not trying to be ad hominem. I don't believe she's smart at all. And in no way is she a deep thinker. This I know. And she does not have good solutions. She has no solutions. She truly doesn't. She's all over the board. She really is a far left progressive who was literally raised by Marxists. That's what's influenced her policies. That was the true Kamala in 2019. And now she's learned enough to try to say she's more moderate, the Joe Biden plan for getting elected. I don't believe she is. So I do think over the next, you know, 6 to 8 weeks, as early voting starts in mid-September, there's a very good chance that people are going to be reminded of how far left she is and how shallow intellectually she is. Over on Team Trump, he's trying to get better at messaging. I have noticed an increased effort to keep pounding the things that work for him. And so that's good. He needs to continue that. And he needs to still be more message disciplined. You know, yours truly and many others had been saying he's been rambling and it's not working. He's losing his entertainment value, which is one of Trump's main selling points. And so what does he do? He goes out on the campaign trail and says, some people say I ramble. I don't ramble. I have to go on for 2 hours because people wait in line for days to get to see me. With all due respect, this election is not about those people. Those people are going to vote for Trump no matter what. Message discipline is about reaching the critical swing state voters who will determine the next president. So I like these people who go to these rallies. I know a lot of these people, but these people cannot have their wishes and desires to see Trump perform sated at the expense of the White House. So Trump needs to realize that and get back on message discipline. They've each got, you know, some real weaknesses is what I'm trying to say as candidates, never mind on policy.